For this video, we're going to review setting up annotation styles. This will help you get through chapter 11 and 13. It will also help with your final project since you'll have the styles set into your drawing. Go ahead and open your template file and let's build the styles within the template file. I have mine open here. And I'm going to go to the Home tab, Annotation panel, and pull down the annotation styles. So this list here shows us what styles we're currently using. This first one is the text style. Second is the dimension style. Third is the multi-liter style. And last is the table style. So we are going to start by setting up text styles. And if I go to the list here, I can kind of expand and see which ones are already in my drawing. We are going to create a new notes style and a title style. So to create a new style, I will go ahead and come back and click on the icon next to the name and expand the dialog box here. From here, I'm going to do new and give the style a name. I will call this one notes. Click OK. And then I can go ahead and choose the font and any of the factors or properties that go along with this style. I'm going to change the font to City Blueprint. The style can stay regular, and the width factor I have right now set at 0.75, and the book wants us to set it to 1. That's sort of a preference. And once I've made those changes, I can click Apply and close the dialog box. Now when I go to create text within my drawing, I go ahead and choose a multi-line text option here. I can see that the note style is selected up here in the ribbon. This is the size that it's at, and that style will come into my drawing. One other thing to double check on this is making sure that annotative is selected. You may or may not want annotative text, but it's helpful, I think, as we've changed scales within our drawings, that the text size stays consistent throughout. Let's create one additional text style. Go back to the annotation panel and click on the style icon. And if you already have title block within your drawing, go ahead and click on it. If you don't, please create a new style called title block and follow the same prompts. So we can see here the font name is Times New Roman. We'll go ahead and keep that. Style is bold italic. This one is not set to annotative, and we're going to leave that unchecked. And this will make sense when we work on a table later. And our width factor is 1. So these are the style settings for the title block font. So go ahead and you can click Apply. In this case, I haven't made any changes, so I'll go ahead and click Cancel. If I want to create new text within that style, you can go ahead and use multi or single line text. Back to multi-line text. Drag a box. And I can choose the style from up here. And go ahead and create new text. Now Next, we'll create a dimension style. From the annotation panel, go ahead and click on the dimension style icon, which will launch the dimension style manager. And from here, we're going to create a new style, and we will call it interior design. We'll go ahead and start with the annotative style and continue. And then this launches into the style box, and we'll go through each of these tabs and set up our preferences for this style. On the lines tab, we'll go ahead and switch the color to bilayer, line type and line weight also to bilayer. Extend beyond ticks, we'll go ahead and leave that alone. Baseline spacing at 3/8 is great. Extension lines should also be bilayer. All of these pull downs, we are going to choose bilayer. Extend beyond the dimension line, we'll choose 3/32. Offset from origin, 1/16. And we are good with those options. Next, on the symbols and arrows tab, we want to make sure that architectural tick is set for our first and second arrowhead. The leader should be close filled. And the arrow size, 1/16. The rest of this looks consistent with the book. We will leave preceding dimension line text here. And we may come back and adjust the size of the tick marks a little bit later. But for the most part, we didn't have to change much on this style. Next, let's go to text. The settings for the text tab are indicated here. For text style, set it to notes. Color and fill set to bilayer, none, text height 1/8, fraction height 1, and for text placement, we're going to vary somewhat from the book so that we are consistent with general styles in the industry. So for vertical, choose above. For horizontal, choose centered, and view direction left to right. And over here on the right side where it says text alignment, you want to choose aligned with dimension line. Next, we'll move to the fit tab, and we will choose either text or arrows, best fit. Text placement. This is really a preference. I prefer it over the dimension line without a leader. But you may have a preference otherwise. And then on fine tuning over here, I prefer to have the system draw the lines for me. And if I need to override them, I can do it later. If I choose place text manually, then I will have to manually place it every time I do a dimension line. So again, that's a preference, and you can choose whether or not to place it manually or let it be automatic. Under the primary units tab, make sure that your unit format is set to architectural and precision to 1/16 inch. And don't believe there's anything else we need to change on this. Your zero suppression, you could have, it's 0 feet is default. We could also put in 0 inch if we want to have that show up for us. There's nothing that we need to change on alternate units or tolerances. We can leave those as they are. So once you've gone through each tab and set up your preferences, click OK and set current. So now the interior design style will be current within our drawings. And I'll go ahead and close that. And let's do a little demonstration. So I'm drawing a rectangle. And I will quickly place some dimensions on it. So there we go. Now you have the style. So the only thing different, really different from the book, is the vertical dimensions. The text actually follows the dimension line instead of being read vertically. I prefer this. This is industry standard. It's often done differently if you're drawing elevations for maybe a cabinet millwork shop or something like that. Next, we're going to set up a multi-liter style. So in the same location on the annotation panel, just under our dim style is the multi-liter style icon. So go ahead and click to activate that. And we will create a new style called label. And we'll make that annotative and continue. Now we'll go through each of the tabs. Leader format will remain straight for the type. Color by layer, line type, and line weight we'll choose by layer. And your arrowhead you can choose. We can leave, go ahead and leave that as a closed filled arrow, but you can expand the panel to see the other options that are provided. For leader structure, we're going to leave the maximum leader points at 2. And let's see if we're changing anything else. Set landing distance, I'm gonna change that to 1/4 inch. And annotative is selected. Then we'll go on to the content panel and we'll go ahead and leave the type as multi-line text. The style we can set as notes, and you can see it changed here on the right. We'll keep horizontal for the angle, switch the color to by layer, and the height to 1/8 of an inch. And we'll leave all of the settings. We'll leave horizontal attachment here, middle of top line for the left, and we'll go ahead and repeat that for the right, and leave the gap as is, and click OK, and set current. Close the dialog box. Now, if you want to create a multi-liter, you can click on the multi-liter icon and go ahead and create a new multi-liter. Don't have my caps lock on for that. And close. So at any point, we may want to go back and review if these arrowheads or tick marks are too big. This is representing 1/2 inch scale, so we can change this at any time.